Hello everyone, Mirageflight here, bringing you another game of Company of Heroes 2, this time between against Easy, who will be in the north as our Soviet player, against Clocklabs, who will be our Austrian player, here down south of Langreskya, and uh-oh, we're freezing up here. Okay, we're back. Technical difficulties have been solved, I didn't do anything. Anyways, we got two conscripts coming out for our Soviet player, well, meanwhile, I got two Grenadier squads coming out for our Axis player. Nothing too unusual. Meanwhile, combat engineers are moving into the northern area. We'll be capping and may even try to harass the fuel later on. Conscripts are moving down onto the right-hand side. We'll begin capturing in the points and onto the fuel. The second conscript squad will probably move onto the cutoff. Oh, excuse me. Now, I'm just going to have general capping for a bit of time. Langreskya is a relatively... I think it's okay in size. Not the biggest 1v1. But it does take a bit of time in the early game to get the places. Anyways, on to the commanders for Easy. I'm pretty sure that's how you say his name. We got guard mortar coordination tactics, lend-lease tactics, and shock rifle frontline tactics. And we got Clocklabs has lightning war doctrine, mobile defense doctrine, and close air support doctrine. Nothing too unusual from these players. Here's to be honest, you don't have things like storm doctrine or joint operations or conscript support tactics or other crazy doctrines being used at the moment. I'm going to have our first infrastructure combat here. Building the building combat. Actually, all the conscripts actually jump out of the house. Should probably get back in there. All sides have enough windows for all their squads to fire at each other, I think. We got four windows here, and we got also two windows on that side. We also got a conscript squad moving up, and my mouse is messing up here. I really need to grab a new one. Okay, we're back. Onto the engagement. Grenadiers will be engaging these conscripts. Probably will win here. Conscripts are in an inferior position. Short range engagement here. Grens are actually winning this. They do have more health than men. 3 versus 4, and conscripts are getting very low on health. Meanwhile, the Austria player still hasn't captured his field near, so his pioneer is still doing the capping. Combat. Conscripts are going to be jumping into the house here. Can also begin harassing points down the south. Combat engineers are also moving in. Our all conscript squads in the north on the right-hand side of the map have been driven off, and the field's now being contested. More conscripts are coming out for Easy. Our munition point is under attack. Pioneers will spot this, but they won't be able to do much. We actually had double... those are combat engineers. I'm getting the icons mixed up. Axes are always red. Allies are always blue. Combat engineers will begin grabbing the cutoff. We'll come under fire from grenadiers. We got another grenadier squad coming up from the rear. These grenadiers are actually getting ripped apart as they're standing in the open. Pioneers have captured the field north and will begin moving up. Conscripts are redirecting the fire. However, grenadiers do in the back do have superior position. Arms are going to attempt to close in and deal with these grenadiers. However, they're taking heavy damage. Grenadiers don't actually do that low DPS. The main reason they lose at short range to conscripts is due to the fact conscripts have 80 health per model. They simply can't cut through it all before they lose their DPS in time. However, conscripts have been forced off. Combat engineers are doing what they can. We do have another conscript squad coming out, however, to harass. We'll be able to drive away these combat engineers. Pioneers are coming down. Combat engineers have been forced off, but these grenadiers are going to need to pull back.
The enemy is attempting to steal our sector.
Grenadiers are coming back out of the base. We'll begin moving up. Fuel on the right-hand side has been captured, but it's currently not connected. Looks like we have a small engagement here. I see a body. The grenadiers were forced off. See Vera's rifle, so we had casualties on both sides. Grenadiers fighting from behind the wall. We'll be able to drive away the conscripts. Our point remains decapped. We got more and more grenadiers come out. We are currently sending out 5 grenadier squads. Once the LMGs start kicking in, it's going to be a real pain for a Soviet player. Currently no tech out for a Soviet either. Field mechs have been bought though. Point will be recaptured, reconnecting the fuel. Conscript squad will be forced to recapture their Soviet fuel on the right hand side of the map. Grenadiers should probably mass up and attack the building all at once. Battle phase 1 is under research.
This is not
Grenadiers should be able to win this eventually. We'll probably suffer casualties, though. Our Grenadiers actually moved up. I'm not sure why they moved up. Maybe trying to go for the cutoff, but they've been forced off. Flamethrower is here. We'll help force away 80 units out of the building. However, these Pioneers should probably move closer inward to the building, so those Conscripts couldn't shoot at them. Both Conscripts was forced to pull back. Very low health. Thankfully, there are medics in the base now. Not a really good place for the Conscripts. They're standing in the middle of the open. Two of them are actually standing in the open, taking that additional received accuracy and damage. If you're not sure what those stats are, it's 25% extra damage and 25% increased accuracy. And you also take a lot more suppression. Flamethrower is here for our Soviets. Forces the Grenadiers out of the building. I'd say map control is maybe a bit favoring our Axis. Currently, they're down by like two territory, but at least mainly these two down themselves. Oh, then we'd have a bit more even melt. Grenadier's gonna be forced to pull back. Once again, my mouse is a bit buggy, so don't be surprised if my screen suddenly locks up when the action is going on. I really need to grab a new mouse. I'm not sure why these Conscripts are not sticking to cover and just trying to duel the Grenadiers in the building. It's needless manpower loss. They're not going to get out of the building if they're just standing in the open. Battle Phase 2 is coming up. Easy has also locked into his doctrine, getting himself guard. He went guard more coordination tactics, got himself his guards. DP-28s are on their way. However, more units need to reinforce these guards. They're not going to be able to take on these three Grenadier squads who are also jumping into the building. One Conscript squad will be moving down onto the cutoff to harass. We actually lost a Conscript squad. Rifle grenade, I think it was. Ability is on cooldown. Another rifle grenade is going off.
Enemy is taking our territory.
Guards do manage to dodge it. Conscripts engaging the Pioneers. Depending how the Conscripts get into their accuracy, they should be able to force away the Pioneers, though they're taking quite a bit of damage. These Grenadiers are going to be forced off by the guards, though. Guards have taken heavy casualties, so he can put some Conscripts into the squad to keep them on the field longer. Still no tech for his Soviets. No tier 1 or 2, and no tier 3 yet, and we're 7 minutes into the game. They've only been in constant infantry combat throughout the game. Field North is being harassed by Conscripts. These Conscripts should probably get out of there, or at least get behind cover. However, more Conscripts have arrived. Could probably walk into the circle and deny the capture. I think he should have bought an MG42 at one point, though. It would help him defend a lot easier. Also makes trading manpower less in the manpower bleed, as you're not really trading infantry models for between the two sides. Do have Grenadiers still on the right-hand side. Combat engineers and guards can move in and try to take them on. Alright, a massive of Axis infantry are coming out of the base. Cut-off has been decapped. Alright, these Conscripts need gal there. There's no way they can fight all this, even at that too. Our northern fuel has been captured. Map control has shifted. Meanwhile, combat engineers are capturing the right-hand side.
The sector is at risk.
Grenadiers are not moving in just yet, not sure why. Tier 2 is up, we will have support weapons for our Soviets. Could see Tier 3 being plopped down shortly. We also have another combat engineer squad going for flamethrowers, again. Oh, there's no micro on that combat engineer, they still managed to dodge a grenade. Needs to pull that combat engineer squad back. Wasn't paying attention, could possibly lose him on retreat. He's at very low health. And he does lose, and he drops a flamethrower. That's very bad for Soviets. Needs to be paying attention. Currently, our Axis are in the infantry lead. We have 5 Grenadier squads and a Pioneer squad. Now a pack gun also coming out to deal with possible any armor. Rifle grenade goes out and wipes out the combat engineers. And they're not going well for Easy. He's getting unlucky on a lot of things. And he also lost 2 squads when he was not paying attention. Grenadier's going to be a bit of pain since he has all the flamethrower. And they get the Conscript short-range advantage. Flamethrower is going off and doing significant damage. And the Grenadiers are also vet 2. Conscripts are now vet 2. However, these Grenadiers will pull out. And my mouse is once again going off. Guards are engaging Grenadiers. Grenadiers will jump into the house. A big disadvantage for a Soviet player. He does not have much infantry. He's been forced to rebuild all the combat engineer squads. I'd probably prefer to spend that manpower elsewhere. Maxim is on the field. Guards should probably join in the fight.
Combat engineers are standing by.
Conscripts in the open. Rough grenade does go off. And we'll match. We'll not get the decap on the point. Grenadiers are attempting to close in, but conscripts will pull back. May possibly lose these Grenadiers on retreat. They have to go to this guard squad. And the PTRS knocks that guy down. What a kick in the head. Anyways, still map control is reverting back to our Germans. His superior infantry advantage. Down to 4 Grenadiers though. Maxim should be able to help out though. Max is currently not sitting on that many munitions. He has been using quite a few rifle grenades. No LMGs have popped either.
We are ready to go, comrade.
Battle phase 2 is underway. Point has been decaptured. Going to need reinforcements here. Guards will shoot through these pioneers. Or they should be able to shoot. Grenade does go off. It's not dodged. Pioneers take heavy damage but are not wiped. We'll be forced to pull back. Could have been worse. Guards are being focused by 2-3 Grenadier squads. Need to pull back, but they're pulling through 2 more Grenadier squads and they're running across the road. Actually, they're not getting negative cover, but they may get wiped regardless. And Maxim, however, will save that guard squad by suppressing the Grenadiers from moving up. Our squad is here. All Grenadiers in the south have been suppressed. Our squad is moving up. We'll probably try to get rifle grenade off. Maxim is moving. Squad does spread out very nice. Will not take any damage from that. Now the conscripts are engaging Grenadiers here. Force away another squad. Flamethrower from the other Grenadier squad is engaging, however. We'll force away these conscripts. And the Maxim. Well, Maxim will do what it needs to do. Grenadiers are trying to capture the center VP. VPs haven't really dropped for either side. It is Langreskya. We are 477 versus 441. Currently 8 CPs in, and we haven't even seen one light vehicle. Just a lot of infantry combat. I'm sorry, man. There's no one gonna save you, because this game is cruel. There are no field mechs in this game to save our casualties. No more conscripts are capturing. Map control is evening out. Maxim in the house is gonna be difficult to deal with. Might get suppressed here. Probably not taking suppression, despite the fact he's not, shouldn't be getting cover from this angle, but could be the fact that Maxim's aiming at that very one guy, but they will get suppressed eventually. Guards cannot throw a grenade, they're just gonna fight here. Rough grenade does go off. Guards do manage to dodge, but they still have taken heavy damage. We actually have a mortar out to try and deal with this thing. A mine went off and killed 3 members of the Pioneer squad. Flamethrower is going to try and smoke up Maxim regardless, though. We got the Flamethrower Grenadier is also coming up. Okay, now Maxim's in a really bad position. Could actually lose it if he doesn't bail out of it. He will manage to save that Maxim. It is Vet 1. Maxims are very good since the last patch. They will actually suppress people who are too close to each other. These conscripts in patrol dealing with 2 Grenadiers. They are backpedaling. We do have the tier 3 now up for austere player. Still no tech for our Soviet player, so we're not going to be spotting armor coming out for him. Hopefully he realizes that he can no longer call in T-34s like he used to. All units down on this side will be forced away. This squad needs to pull back. They're in way too much danger. They're going to have to deal with 2 Grenadier squads on the retreat path. And we do lose him. Pulled out way too late.
Troops have been lost.
You really cannot pull out on 2 to 3 men when you're engaged by that many grenadiers. Grenadiers are very ridiculous squads that consider good accuracy. They're even more ridiculous when they get their LMG. Grenadiers will manage to get the capture on the right hand side before pulling back. Guard squad is coming down the move and capture hour. Our building's still smoking here, thankfully it's not on fire. Mortar is here. We'll begin bombing Maxim. However, Maxim's already repositioned. Mortar's going to need to pack up our risk and wipe. Unfortunately, guards do not have their grenade ready. They don't have ammunition. Rougher grenade has gone off. These conscripts are pulling back. Soviet constantly harassing his opponent. Right, we do have another Maxim coming out. Well, actually, that was the new Maxim. We'll provide some firepower against all these grenadiers, since it's been forcing Clocklabs to constantly use his munitions. He only has one LMG. A lot of his other munitions have been spent on rifle grenades. We still have a lot of mines down for our Soviets, and we do not have sweepers yet. Will be a real big pain when Clocklabs decides to get his armor out. Should also probably spend some manpower. He's quite a bit in the bank.
Our opponents are seizing a sector.
Guards need to be engaging immediately. However, they're getting ripped in by two grenadier squads. Flamethrower is also coming up. Grenadiers will manage to get the dodge, but do take some health damage. Miner's trying to move up. However, Maxim will stop them from getting onto the cutoff. I don't think the conscript is going to win this simply because of the flamethrower and the AoE. Maxim does take a rifle grenade, doesn't actually lose that many crewmen. Does take a bit of, damage, though. Conscripts force away. This grenadier squad has quite a few kills, 28. I think it's currently the highest out of all the grenadiers. The one with the LMG is one kill behind our. They have a mortar moving out, we'll begin capturing, and we'll be able to bomb the building once it sets up. Do have tier 3 coming up. Have a lot of fuel for our Soviets, but he doesn't have the manpower to buy anything at the moment. It'll take a few more minutes. Tier 3 has come up, and we do have a Panzer 4 coming up. We also have a sniper coming out. Will be useful against the guards, as well as slowly chipping away the Maxims.
We have a new sniper under our command.
Mortar is bombing the building.
The enemy is taking our territory. Sneaking
down from the conscripts, forcing them out. This is very late vehicle play from both players. We got pretty much the 18-minute Panzer 4, and we still have no armor from our Soviets. Both sides have been constantly throwing infantry at each other. Flamethrower is coming up. Our LMG is firing on the squad. Panzer 4 is here. This gun needs to rotate down. We do have AT grenades, but sadly... Oh, actually, we do have conscript. Two conscripts. I thought we had less. And that Panzer 4 is going to hit a mine the moment it backs up. We have to move forward instead rather than backing up, though. Still takes two hits from this gun. That could have been really bad if he actually went backward, though. It was this... It was like, what, less? Pretty much the moment it backed up even a little, the mine would detonate. The entire building goes down, and I think we just lost a conscript squad. We only have one conscript squad left, so we don't really have many means to throw anti-tank grenades, nor do we have the munitions, though. Really bad place for our Soviets at the moment. Sniper is here, where we're getting picking away merits. He's taking a little bit of damage, but he does have 5 kills under his belt.
Enemy forces are securing our territory.
Soviet player is now actually building his tier 4. Could go for his 85s, or he could also try to get the 2 T-34-76s on the field. T-34-85 is still generally better than any way for it, except for a bit of speed. Finally, we have a lonely action. Axis are really trying to push up on the map. Would be an easy back into the position he once was at the start of the game. Our guards are beginning to capture this. Lightning War has been locked in for us, for our austere player.
Infantry can march double time at your command.
Then he laughed and told me who he was. How can we help?
Not sure what he's going to build from his tier 4 or tier 3. He got them up relatively late because of his infantry losses. This gun is barraging. Does he even have line of sight? Because he's just simply giving away the position of his gun. And now sniper and LMG. Well, actually, that's a G44 gun. Not sure if it's the best idea on this map. Starts trading with grenadiers. Our grenadiers have more veterancy. And our Panzer IV has hit a mine on its way to the guard squad. I thought the guards are actually going to lose this engagement. They have not yet hit that 3. Grenadiers have to actually survive the booty. Maxim is here. We'll suppress the grenadiers. Our Kalaf has been captured. Flamethrower is moving up on the sniper. Sniper almost got taken out. Our engineers were a bit slow to fire once they stopped. Mortar is going to be landing in the area. Combat engineers need to get out of there. Maxim is coming out of the base. We got an 85 coming out of the building. We'll be able to deal with a lot of the targets on the field. Could see a Stug come out harder for our Steer play to try and counter, or just another Panzer IV to overwhelm the 85.
Enemy forces are attempting to capture our territory.
Rifle grenade going off on the Maxim. Takes a bit of damage, but the Grenadier squad still gets pinned in the end. Mortarhauer is here. Grenadiers are here. We'll be engaged. I think the Grenadiers are going to lose this one simply because they don't have cover. He is going to try and get a rifle grenade off. And it actually bugs out. You don't see the animation. Probably Hey, Ruck needs to fix that so you can actually tell the rifle grenade's going off or not. Because you always get the toss animation. Or you can generally see the toss animation for regular grenades. The only time I think you would have difficulty seeing it if the squad is suppressed or something and they're on their bellies and trying to toss that grenade from there. Currently, Clocklabs does have a massive lead. He's sitting on field crew and manpower. 85 is taking hits. Needs to begin moving back, however. Could get faster here. My mouse is once again acting up. Faust does go through. Panzer IV really shouldn't chase, though. We'll need repairs on this 85. More Maxim fire. Pack gun is trying to rotate. 85 is going back up, however. We finally have an MG42 on the field. This gun barrage is going down the house, however. House is not going to last that long. May actually lose. House collapses. MG42 is gone. Well, more like leave the entire squad because you're all dead now. Alright. Maxim is being forced away. Pioneers to move out will hit that mine. Mortar forced away by Ford Maxim. Sniper on the field and still picking away on models.
We are losing a sector.
85 will be back in action shortly. Could see an SU-76 come out and stay behind the TU-34, would also save a bit of fuel. Could deal with the Panzer IV from range while the 85 guards it. But also gives them a mobile barrage. And the guards are in a bit of trouble here, need to pull back. Sniper will miss his shot. 85 is back in action. Soviets continue to move up. Panzer IV is now back in action. We're now back to... No, we're still at 4 grins. I thought he actually may have bonded another one. This gun's in the open, needs to begin moving. It doesn't want to get rifle grenade. Maxim will suppress this Grenadier squad. You can see it has a very fast pin time with your targets in the open, and now that we've vet, it does it really well. Our stun shot does go off. Combat injury is being forced off. This could be a bit dangerous for the Grenadiers. They are running right into the tank. And even if he does get the foul stop, 85 is not low enough on health to get that engine crit. Tiger is on the field. Been a while since we've seen one of these. Another engagement. Maxim is once again proving its worth. Grenade trying to go off. Our squad is in cover. Do take a bit of damage, but could have been worse. Mortar is firing, however. What, do we actually have a 120 on the field? Not exactly the best mortar since the changes. But we're no longer down into that wipe machine where pretty much every... so often was going to wipe a squad no matter what you did. Tiger is here. Tanks are taking a toll on the guards. This could be really bad for Easy. He doesn't really have anything counter. He does have a Zisk gun facing. Will not get a shot in hour. Alright, goodbye. Try to save up manpower for two SU-76s. They would do really well against all this armor and barrage. All the barrage things like the pack gun. It's also a map that favors long-range units simply because it's so open on the right-hand side. Maxim's doing what it can. But it's not going to do much against the Tiger. T-34 is moving in way too deep. Could possibly lose our tank here, and we do lose it. Mark target has been activated. How we have no damage on this tank, so even if there was an AT grenade thrown, it's not going to do anything. That did not slow down at all. We're going to lose our Zisk gun. Don't really have much manpower for us, so we can't currently buy any anti-armor vehicles. This may actually be it for a Soviet player. Yep, that's it for Easy. He simply had no manpower by the end of the game, even though he did have the field to bring out possible tank destroyers or assault guns. As he's facing a much stronger army, he's been simply got those Clocklabs managed to preserve his squads a lot easier, though Easy did have was quite a bit unlucky with those combat engineers. He forgot about the ones on the right hand side until they were forced to read through at pretty much one member, and very unlucky rifle grenade near the center took out his utter flamethrower. You really had him back, couldn't really deploy any light vehicles early on. But regardless, good aim to Clocklabs, bear luck next time to Easy. And this is Mirage Fla, signing off.